So a while back, I started working on this little platformer game. It was pretty good, like it had some fun mechanics and a lot of levels, but it wasn't amazing by any means. Definitely not good enough to be my most successful game ever. So I shared it on Scratch, expecting it to get maybe a few views. Yeah, it is by far my most successful game ever, and it's even the 146th most viewed game on Scratch, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna make another one, because at the end of the game, I promised I would make a sequel if it got a million views. Which it did. The first thing we need is a square, and also some coding to make the square move and have physics and stuff. Just like all my code, it's working perfectly on the first try. Okay, now it's working great. We can jump and move and stuff. I would explain the player physics in detail, but they're not very unique, and talking about code and numbers isn't very entertaining. Here's the code on screen if you're interested, and let me know in the comments if you'd like me to explain my code more in future videos. My next priority is to make the game look kind of good. A lot of game devs say that you should work on the game art and visuals only after programming and perfecting the base mechanics, but I am always more motivated to continue working on a game if it looks good during development. I'll copy the player art and animations from the first Mellow game, and now the square is officially Mellow. He doesn't look very good in-game, so I'll code the animations so that they actually work. That looks great. The animations are now done, and Mellow looks very good now. I'll also refine the controls so that they match the original game more closely. Anyway, I wasn't quite sure what I wanted the game to look like, so I started browsing the internet for inspiration, as I often do. I found this great-looking game called Q, a neon platformer, and I decided to try to recreate the glowing look of the platforms in Scratch. Scratch doesn't have any built-in post-processing of any kind, so simply adding a bloom effect to... Scratch doesn't have any built-in post-processing of any kind, so simply adding a bloom effect to the level edges isn't possible. The effect that I did manage to create looks okay, but it's basically just many colored outlines drawn around the level. I do end up improving it later in the development process, but for now it looks like this. Next, I need to make some basic mechanics so the game isn't too boring. In the majority of Scratch platformers, you win the level when you move the player off the right side of the screen, but to win a level of Mellow, you need to touch a flag that can be anywhere inside the level, even off-screen in another direction, which means there are already many more level design possibilities than the typical Scratch platformer. I've also added moving platforms, which are platforms that move, obviously, and can move the player with them. Also, there are spikes and bouncy trampolines. Now I've got to actually make some levels to introduce these mechanics, and then challenge the player to use them. It's been about a week of development, and the good news is that all the mechanics are working well and there are no bugs that I know of. The bad news is that the game isn't fun to play. Sometimes when I find the game that I'm working on is boring, I like to take a step back and carefully analyze the problem, and to consider every aspect of the playing experience to determine what is making it unenjoyable. If I can't determine the problem on my own, it is useful to have other players test the game and provide feedback. In this case, my sisters played the levels that I have made and gave me their thoughts. They thought that the levels were annoyingly difficult to play, and the ridiculous amount of obstacles made the game feel slow and tedious to get through. So I removed some of the spikes and simplified the platform designs, and the game is now feeling much better to play. Also, I gave Mellow a farmer's hat, because someone on Scratch gave me the idea. So thank you to this person. Now that I have a few levels, it's time to begin writing some story for this game. You might think that that is easy to do, but I have a bit of a problem. Over the last year, through dialogue in another game that I shared on Scratch, I accidentally implied the existence of an entire multiverse involving at least three of my past games. Let me explain. This is Mellow, in his own self-contained game without much story. You already know him. Then there's this wizard man from another game, also without much story. And then, there's this RPG platformer game I made called The Kingdom of Nor. The thing is, as soon as you start to play the Kingdom of Nor, you see the wizard man, standing in a cave. If you walk up to interact with him, he starts talking, very ominously, about Mello. Mello doesn't exist in this game, or in the game that the wizard originally came from. Something is going on here. I didn't actually have a plan when I wrote this dialogue, or any intention to actually follow through with this story. But now I need to write a crossover narrative that ties together all the flimsy lore of these three unrelated games. Or I could just ignore all of this and write something else, but that isn't as fun. So I wrote it. But I won't read it to you. Mello 2 won't tell the full story, and I plan to keep developing it in future Scratch projects, so I don't want to spoil it here. As days turned into weeks, I kept adding new features to the game, such as these angry squares that try to crush you, cannons that shoot you, these things that don't shoot you, some swinging axe blades, objects that switch your gravity, and obviously, more levels. In total, I made 50 unique level designs for this game. Now, something I didn't anticipate when I made the first Mello game was the small speedrunning community that would develop. If for some reason you don't know what speedrunning is, it's basically where you try to complete a game as quickly as possible. Mello even got its own page on speedrun.com that, to this day, still has a very active player base. To make Mello 2 easier to speedrun, I'm going to include the option to run an in-game timer. That way, speedrunners will know exactly how long they've been playing for. Then, using the help of fontmeme.com, I created this neon-style main menu screen. It has some settings and stuff, and yeah, I made a main menu. Time to share the game. If you want to play the game yourself, there is a link in the description where you can try it out for free. If you like this video, please like this video, and please subscribe to my channel. It takes only one click, and it helps me out a lot.